She had seen miners and prospectors whose eyes shone with a strange glory of light that gold inspired, but never as those of Kells's bandit legion. Presently Joan discovered that, despite the excitement, her effect upon them was more marked than ever, and by a difference that she was quick to feel. But she could not tell what this difference was, how their attitude had changed. Then she set herself the task of being useful. First she helped bait wood. He was roughly kind. She had not realized that there was sadness about her until he whispered, "Don't be downcast, miss. Maybe it'll come out right yet." That amazed Joan. Then his mysterious winks and glances, the sympathy she felt in him, all attested to some kind of a change. She grew keen to learn, but she did not know how. She felt the change in all the men. Then she went to Pierce, and with all a woman's craft, she exaggerated the silent sadness that had brought quick response from Wood. Red Pierce was even quicker. He did not seem to regard her proximity as that of a feminine thing which roused the devil in him. Pierce could not be other than coarse and vulgar, but there was pity in him. Joan sensed pity and some other quality still beyond her. This lieutenant of the bandit Kells was just as mysterious as Wood. Joan mended a great jagged rent in his buckskin shirt. Pierce appeared proud of her work. He tried to joke. He said amiable things. Then, as she finished, he glanced furtively around. He pressed her hand. "I had a sister once," he whispered. And then, with a dark and baleful hate, "Kells, he'll get his over in the gold camp."